This disabled gaming reviews Let's Play is best enjoyed in front of a computer monitor and or tablet with the speakers on. And to any epileptics out there, please watch this in a well-lit environment to reduce the risk of any potential seizures. This DGR Police Party is also unofficially sponsored by Boom and Mini Boom in Air. So Boom and Mini Boom are a geek boutique where if you're looking for things like Dragon Ball mugs, alien figurines, etc., etc., definitely check them out. Did I also mention that they're an official Warhammer retailer? So if you're looking for extra fire team squads to add to your Tau army, definitely check them out. They are located opposite Airbus Station. Look out for the Deadpool statue. Links to Boom and Mini Boom's Facebook page is in the video's description below. Now with all that aside, please enjoy the video. What is everyone, Sparkerman, a 1992 veteran disabled game reviews here. Welcome to part 15 of my Let's Play of Half-Life for the PC. So, yep, we've got all the settings in order. Jolly good. So, anyway. So, part 15 of my Let's Play of Half-Life for the PC. So, the last time we left the Black Mesa Science Facility as we went into the Border World's End. But unfortunately, the welcoming committee wasn't too welcoming as we went head-to-head with the queen of all headcrabs, the Gonarch. As I piled crossbow bolt after crossbow bolt after crossbow bolt against his gonad. And then eventually, she got taken down. So, the last part, when we did the Source Engine run, it was a 25th anniversary celebration of Half-Life, and the episode was extended to 50 minutes. Yep, and we are going to replicate that in this part. Okie doke. Ready for this? Heck yeah. 3, 2, 1... Stop the timer. 50 minutes, go, go, go. Sadly enough, I don't have enough ammo for that one. Which really would have been helpful if I were to actually had. I
shot thing. So you've got 45 minutes remaining, James. Thank you very much, Dales. So let's turn and burn. Tails, what did it say about using Top Gun references? While we're waiting for this lift, whatever this is, to come down, we'll go with our open question. So, lately, Ubisoft CEO said that because we're going towards an all digital future, that would mean that we're going to have to get comfortable not owning our games. So, what do you think about all this? Do you think that, would you rather buy a game on physical media so you could play that game offline, or would you rather go over a disc-free list but with restrictions because the developer can take that game right away from you with no refunds? Which is... let me know down in the comments. Gonna love that jankiness of Half-Life physics. Guess that works.
Major fracture detected. Emergency. User dead imminent.
I can't hit that guy. Seems as though I'm gonna got plenty of ammo.
Thank you. Damn it. Right. Go, go, go. Okay. Minutes. Crowbar right, you spoon. Surprise, I'm dead again. Oof. Thank goodness. Get ready to go. That's good. Excellent. To go up that one. Thank you. let's reload an earlier save. Most hardest chapter in the game. Thank you. 25 minutes, James. Get 25 more minutes and then that's it. Annoying guys. This is borderline raging just on me. Luckily enough, I've got the sign brew that I have to keep me calm. Yes, that did it. Let's stop the jump. Okay, let's save game. This one. This is good. Go. Good. That's the big advantage of constantly saving games like this. Got him through.
Joy, see, I'm gonna have to restart the whole thing again.
Thank you.
does kind of make sense. So I don't need to completely take that guy down. I just need to evade him. Minutes left, James. That's it, follow me, follow me, follow me, that's it, come on. No. So that will be doing us for today, and we will be able to get through this blimmin' part hopefully by next time. Until then, I'll see you then.